joins me in just a moment. When you think about great leaders in hockey, you think about Howe, Clark, and Messier, not often a guy between the pipes, unless it's Patrick Roy. What comes to mind when one thinks of Patrick Roy? His great glove hand?
Here's Fedorov's shot.
His record and reputation as one of the most successful goalies ever to play the game. Or maybe his confident attitude.
I can't really hear what Jeremy says because I got my two Stanley Cup rings plugged in my ear.
All this most certainly is true, but is it the Patrick off the ice that makes him so great?
Apart from what he does on the ice, he's such a tremendous leader in the room and such a voice of wisdom for the guys in and around the team. And the people watching the game see, and they see the greatness on the ice, but they don't really get to see up close how good he is behind the scenes.
Patrick's our leader. He's experienced, and guys respect him a lot, especially the defense. He takes us aside when we're not doing things so well and tries to keep our game simple as, you know, as maybe he wants.
He basically tells us what he wants to do, and he expects us to perform that. Sometimes in a special place, he just expects you to be in a place and do what you're supposed to do, and he trusts you.
Trust. I mean, they trust me, and I trust them. If it's a 2-on-1, I know they're going to get the pass, and I know I'm going to have to make the save on the shot. Then they got a confidence that I'm going to make the save, and I got a confidence they're going to cut the pass.
That confidence is formed by playing with each other day in and day out and realizing the differences in each defenseman's game, like Sylvain Lefebvre.
As a guy that play stay-home defenseman, I mean, you're going to see most of him in our end, and he could be very physical, but he's also a guy that like to control the play in our end by throwing the puck out of the zone. He's a very safe player.
Alexei Gusarov.
He's a defenseman who reads the play very well. And he's not necessarily physical, but he's going to be really smart and he's going to put himself in a great position.
Sandis Ozolinch.
Ozo is a different guy. I've got to learn to play with Ozo because he's a guy that needs to go offense. This year, I think he find a way to pace himself a little more. Finding the right time to go off.
Adam Foote.
I really love Adam. He's already a very good leader on our team, and he's going to become more and more with experience in more years. He's a guy that plays extremely well defensively, but also he's playing very physical, and it's something that you like to see from a defenseman.
I learn something every day being around that guy and how he just wants to win so bad and how he brings confidence to himself, to me, and the team. And just to be a winner, being around a guy like that, it rubs off on you, I think.
It's nice from them what they're saying, but I mean, I deserve no credit of that. I just tried to help the guys, but I mean, I deserve no credit at all.
Well, he deserves some credit because this series would be over if not for Patrick Roy.
When I listen to this about Patrick, and he's won two Stanley Cups with Montreal and here with Colorado, so he's a perfect fit for those teams he played on, but there's no blueprint for a goaltender that fits in a team. Grant Fuhr has won 5 Stanley Cups with Edmonton, and talking to Wayne and talking to Marty, he was the perfect goaltender for Edmonton. He was very quiet. He never says anything. He just goes out and plays. He doesn't care if he has 1 breakaway a game against or 5 breakaways a game against. He's always working. He'll stop the next breakaway, whereas Patrick is a perfect fit for Montreal when he was there, and now the perfect fit for Colorado. So there's no blueprint for the perfect goaltender on the perfect team. A guy like Patrick will win anywhere, and a guy like Grant Fuhr will win anywhere. So it's but Patrick's special without a doubt.
Yeah, confidence definitely starts from